We are Penn State.
So what's going on, guys? Welcome to another video, and finally the day has come. College football is rolling tonight. I'm in the car right now, about to drive to Indiana to go to see my uncle, like stay at my uncle's place tonight, go hang out there, have some dinner, and then we are driving together to the University of Purdue for the Penn State Nittany Lions versus the Purdue Boilermakers. I've been saying, hopefully a Penn State W. Hopefully my boy Colt gets in, eats some pancakes, because he's always my boy. If you play football, you know. No matter where you go, if you stop playing after high school, you're brothers for life. So, nothing but the best for him. Still hoping for a Penn State W. One thing that stinks is I get to miss the backyard brawl, because it's been nonstop comedy for me watching all the Penn State and West Virginia fans go after each other, which is always just funny. But hey, I'm finally going to my first college football game. They said wear all white, wear your white. I got my white on. I'm ready for this game. About to make a 2-hour drive. Listen to some Penn State type music that all my Penn State fans know that gets blasted in the stadium, what we love to use. So get that blasting, make this couple hour drive, and I'll see you probably at the stadium.
Fucking first half, baby. My God. Let up a field goal to start the game. Then we drive it down, make it 7-3. Then they end up going, taking it back down to make it 10-3. Then Penn State, with our worries with the offense sometimes, actually went back to answer, make it 14-10. And then right before the half, with 30 seconds remaining, Purdue fumbles. Penn State recovered. Challenge on the play because they believed our guy was out of bounds, but of course he wasn't, stayed in bounds. End up being Penn State ball with 30 seconds remaining, 3 timeouts. First play, PI, 15 yards, automatic first. Second play, dud. And then we throw a bomb. Ends up being caught. would have been already, it was already perfect enough field goal range to get at least three before the half because Purdue gets the ball. But then he breaks off a couple of tackles like they were nothing, scores it. Now it's 21-10 Nittany Lions. Let's go. And another key note with the band now starting is that my boy Josh Comer, when they score the field goals in the PAT, I made sure to watch him and only him because that is my boy. Because I win no matter what tonight, either Penn State or he does, because he's my brother. And if he wins, I win. That's how brotherhoods work. All right, let's keep it going in the second half. Let's finish this thing. Let's go. We are Penn State.
Okay, so it is currently the next day. I just got home from my uncle's place in Indiana, and I kind of stopped filming because I wanted to enjoy the rest of the game, and plus the nerves were going late in the game. Like, I was so nervous, my leg feeling was gone. My legs were so numb. I was just like, come on. But very, very slow second half for Penn State. Purdue finally got it going. They were catching up, and then went Clifford. And I don't even need to say anything else. All my Penn State fans, we know. But overthrows it, pick six, they take the lead. Offense still can't going. But in the start of the half, our future star, Drew Allar, man, that kid looks good. Like, I know it wasn't long, but some of his ball looked good. Like, that's a nice looking ball he throws. And yeah, but offense was slow. But fortunate enough, at the end, Clifford finally started showing his 6 years, being a 6 year senior, and taking that team down to take the lead right there at the end of the game. And I am still very questioning why. Like, there was one big question in that very final drive with Purdue. Why didn't you not call that timeout? Right on that, I think it was that third down pass, third or fourth down pass. No, second or third down pass, couldn't be fourth. That it was like a 10-plus yard gain, but you let the time go. Like, I get college football off, and the offense now is a no huddle, hurry up, but you need to call a timeout there. You could still run a 10-yard route and get out of bounds with time left on the clock. But because you wasted that much time, you lost that opportunity. That was such a questionable call. And even as a Penn State fan, for all those who watched the game and not just the backyard brawl of Pitt, West Virginia, that what they said was a drop, that was a catch. Like, the scoreboard was hard to see for me because the score on the bottom blocked it, but that was a catch. I believe for all the missed calls that would have went Penn State's way, I believe it was a makeup, but I was shocked that was a catch. But absolutely great game. Absolutely had fun. I enjoyed the little bit of my boy Josh actually got in. I was able to film in. You guys will see it. Wait, because I'm filming this before I start editing the video. Wait, you guys have seen the parts I filmed just fully focused on him. And, like, normally I don't rep other Big Ten schools. I do have a Purdue shirt. Bought this nice Purdue souvenir cup. because I don't mind. Like, I never had a problem with Purdue, and now with him there, I root for them. Like, and for me, this game, I didn't care who won or lost at all. To me, I was going to be happy no matter what, because Penn State wins, great, that's my team. Penn State loses, oh well, he wins, I'm happy for him. He's my brother. And same for all those who play football, you know, you guys are we're all brothers for life. When you share a locker room together, you're brothers for life. So I would have been happy, and it was my first Penn State game. An absolutely great atmosphere, great first night. Way last night was with college football. You had Penn State, Purdue going down the wire. You had Pitt, West Virginia to the wire. If this is how the first Thursday night's starting, this is going to be a fun college football season, and I can't wait. But thanks for watching. Keep it real, everyone. And don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment, and spread the word on these videos. And until next time, peace.